for you, how does it feel to be a part of this year's festival?
It is an honor, and it is something we definitely didn't expect. We are very, very happy that our little movie has been appreciated, especially by non-South African audiences as well.
For people who haven't seen the film yet, can you start by giving us just a brief synopsis and telling us about your character?
My character, well, the movie is about a Muslim family that work in a fabric shop in Fordsburg, South Africa. And the son also works in the fabric shop, played by me. Also secretly does stand-up comedy, and the movie is called Material, and it's basically a bit of a comedy drama, or dramedy if you will, make you laugh and cry, and yeah.
I guess the first and most obvious question, were you familiar with stand-up before you made the film? Was that a big part of your life?
No, I do stand-up comedy, yes. I'm originally qualified as a medical doctor. But my dad used to say, you know, Riyad, you can do whatever you want to in this world as long as you become an orthopedic surgeon first. So no pressure there. But so I got into stand-up comedy after fourth year medicine. And eventually after my internship and community service, the opportunities with the comedy kind of superseded the opportunities with the medicine. And I follow the path of least resistance, and I find myself here chatting to you now. Also, I never really got applause with the medicine. I never got that. It was an amazing prostate exam, doctor. Do you have DVDs of your prostate exams? Never had that. So that's also one of the reasons I moved, shifted fields. I love stand-up because it's honest, and it's a way to tackle hard issues, and make light of it in a sense. It's about survival. That's the essence of comedy. It's about survival. It's about taking these terrible things or difficulties that we have in life and laughing about it, and in so doing, you know, healing ourselves. So this is my thing that I try and tell my parents. You know, I'm still doing a bit of medicine. Laughter is the best medicine, all of that. But it's true, because actually just the act of laughing improves the cardiac output, improves oxygen circulation, improves the T lymphocytic immune cell response. See, I still got it. So it's true, actually, laughter is the best medicine. It's actually good for you.
I think specifically one element of the film obviously is the way in which humor is being used in the film as a way of crossing community boundaries. I think particularly in relation to the Muslim community, how important a role do you think comedy has at increasing tolerance and understanding both within the community and outside?
That's one of the things that I'm most happy about, because this movie is a departure from the general narrative that you see out there surrounding Muslims, which is always involving war, terrorism, things of that nature. Whereas this is just a family story that everyone will be able to relate to. And it's interesting because non-Muslims, non-South Africans, very often come to me afterwards and, you know, just you watch this movie and you realize that Muslims are people like everyone else. And the father was just like my father, and I cried. And it's funny to us, but I guess I understand it. If you're bombarded with a certain perspective from all over, are you going to have these presuppositions? And that's the interesting thing about the film, when you can identify with the pains of the characters that just happen to be Muslim. Hopefully that can break down preconceived notions. And that's one of the things that I am most happy about in this film.
You've already screened the film here in London and further afield, places like Korea. How's the film been received internationally so far?
It was a good career move. Don't worry, my stand-up is better than that. It's been received very well. I mean, we're at Montreal also. Busan yesterday was our first screening, and people absolutely loved it, which is very gratifying, because I'm very paranoid that they won't understand my accent. You know, I'm very, very paranoid. I don't know the English. Oh, David, what language is that? And then it's just me speaking English. That is what I was paranoid about, but they got it in any case. Also the little references, obviously you can't always follow, because the movie is very nuanced, but I think the people do follow the universal themes about family and responsibility and yearning to do something different. So I think the important elements of the film does come across, but that being said, there's a lot of nuances that people miss.